We're glad to be kicking off the series. I've heard so many great things about this series, and I'm glad to see it in person finally. Yeah. You good?
Yes. We're going to get Joe to sing the great Greg Brown composition, There Ain't No One Like You.
Thank you.
guitar playing for you tonight. He's one of the best guitar players I've ever heard, and I think we all feel lucky to be playing with him. Yes. That was one of his tunes called Danny Barnes, and he's called Grant Gordy.
So this is a brand new fiddle tune that appears on the new record. It's called, it's kind of a commemorative piece. It's called The Fiddler's Boot. And it goes somewhat like this. Okay. How'd that get in there? Did we decide a collective decision? Did we decide?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Okay, here we go. Okay, we got another tune, another song. Oh, this is a song, even better than a tune. It's beyond tune. We've gone to song, and so I
think this is your cue, Joe, to sing. Yeah. So Joe has the courage to sing. We look up to him for that.
Oh, we should mention before we do this that you have the great privilege tonight of listening to one of the finest mandolin players and singers happening right now, the great Joe K. Walsh. Please give him a hand.
Here's one I wrote about Arctic exploration and how you shouldn't do it in a balloon.
Zero. Yeah. One, two. Either. situation here with the. This is why I never ask for water on stage, because as soon as it gets poured, my foot gets magnetically attracted to the glass. Okay, somebody's gonna want that, not me.
Not you.
Okay. This is a beautiful tune, and we recorded it also on the record. Weirdly coincidental that we would play it tonight. I think I first heard a guy named Kenny Baker. How many people are familiar with the work of the great fiddle player Kenny Baker? Yeah, one of my heroes. And it's called Dry and Dusty. He kind of gave it a different sort of treatment for this.
Thank you.
cool genre for you. Of course, this is one of the, this is a rapidly expanding demographic in string music. It's gypsy jazz, which is a, it's basically jazz. It's a special kind of guitar.
Not this kind.
Not that kind. Tsk, tsk, tsk. But that's all right, because you know, Django Reinhardt started a revolution in string music that continues to this day. And we're going to kind of just sort of bring, just allude gracefully to the feeling of that kind of music. It's a great tune. Joe wrote this with a good friend of ours, Scott Law, also a great guitar player. It's called The Hunter's Permit.
Oh, sorry. Also, this tune will handily feature some of the incredible skill of our illustrious bass player. This is Aidan O'Donnell on the bass.
Thank you.
Catalog of all, the Ray Charles catalog, called Just a Little Lovin'. Just a little loving, all that I can. If you did, you'd come on home and make dreams come true. Your eyes, your lips, tender kiss seem to linger, yeah. I'll forget, but I won't forget. Just in love.
It's called Farewell Tryon, and it's a beautiful tune. Again, I think it might be from Georgia. I looked up on a map, and apparently there's a Tryon in every state, a town, Tryon in every state south of the Mason-Dixon line. I have no idea what it is about, except that in Tryon, Georgia, because I learned this from a fiddle player from Georgia, James Bryan, there's a town of Tryon where they have a denim factory. And so I can see that if you grow up in Tryon, Georgia, and you want to do anything besides make pants, you probably have to leave. So there's a certain amount of wistfulness with this tune. You know, there's probably some really nice things about the town. If you're leaving, you know, you might actually look over your shoulder and take a look at the town as you leave, and there's a lot of that in this tune. So we're going to play it. Farewell, Tryon. Here we go. Thank you. Thanks. Yeah, there's a little set there of distantly related tunes. What was the other? The Charles Mingus tune. It was the first time we tried that. And it's called Better Get It In Your Soul. And then we just did the Colburn and Grease Fire, a good bluegrass tune that we haven't been playing. This is about the 250th time we played that. So yeah, you get everything. This is a brand new song that is on Joe's new CD that is also out there on the table. And the difference with that one is that we have them. They're still out there. Beautiful CD, just hot off the press, right?
It's not quite off the press yet, but it'll be hot when it is.
It's already hot.
It's coming.
It's hot right now.
Yeah, this is a song I wrote with my friend Chris Moore up in Maine. About, I guess basically there's a quote, it's not, to have somebody that you feel sad enough to, when they're gone is a lucky feeling, I guess. I'm kind of paraphrasing, but that's what this song is about.
Idea and then you try to come up with a nice nice name that fits the mood of the tune. The mood of this tune, I guess, was just where I was sitting, whose apartment I was sitting on the floor of when I started writing this tune. So this is called, amazingly, Ben's House. You're not supposed to laugh that hard.
They can't win.
Okay. Okay, we're gonna slow it down now, folks.
Thank you.
Compass Records website, or you can go to our website, or our general, any of our websites, just about any of our websites, actually.
Really, any website.
And, just and it's all connected now, right? That's what I hear. Okay, so, yeah, are we done? More or less?
Yeah. Yeah, we'll bring it home with, we got one last tune for you. Woo! Thanks to you guys. Thanks for coming out. It's Daryl Anger one more time. Aiden O'Donnell. Grant Reed.
Go, go, go!
And thanks to Paul and Claudia for having us. It's such a wonderful day.
Thank you.
I know, so I can tell if you're any good. It's a fiddle tune, well-known fiddle tune, called Bill Cheatham.